Federal Parliament is tonight working to pass the laws needed to hopefully cushion the economy from total disaster. The Prime Minister has compared the crisis to the Great Depression and encouraged Australians to revive the Aussie spirit. Political editor Chris Yuleman.
A hollowed-out Parliament opens in prayer.
Give us this day our daily bread.
In a chamber stripped back to 90 MPs, another sign that these are unnatural and unnerving days.
For many, young and old, 2020 will be the toughest year of our lives.
Because the economy is being deliberately shut down in a desperate bid to slow the pace of a disease, the sickness will take lives, the cure is killing jobs.
They are lining up at Centrelink offices as we speak.
Lines of despair, once so remote they were the stuff of grandparents' tales.
We listened to those stories and we pictured them in black and white. We thought we were the lucky generations. We now face an enormous threat, and it's in colour.
As the Prime Minister also reached into the dark past to invoke the killer flu of 1919 and the economic horror that followed 1929.
A once in a 100-year event. A global health pandemic that has fast become an economic crisis, the likes of which we have not seen since the Great Depression.
The crisis means Parliament will sit for just one day, even though the opposition has some misgivings about the government's rescue plan.
Selling your super at the bottom of the market will risk squandering people's hard-earned retirement savings.
It will seek amendments, but it won't pick a fight.
Where there is any doubt, we will give the benefit to the government. We are not looking for arguments, we are looking for solutions.
When the House rises, it's not scheduled to sit again until August, and it could be later. And when it returns, Australia will be a very different place.
I most certainly call on all people of faith in our nation to pray.
And hope that these bitter days will soon pass.
We're live to Chris in Canberra now. Chris, it's a pretty big deal when the Prime Minister uses the D word.
Oh, I would have said unimaginable a month ago, Pete, but nothing seems beyond imagining now. Australia hasn't had a recession in 29 years, so most of the workforce doesn't know what an unemployment rate of 10% looks like. At the height of the Great Depression, unemployment peaked at 32%. It lingered for a decade. It killed hopes in the way this virus kills people. And with the whole world shutting down, there will be a recession. The only question now is how wrenching it will be. That's why the government will throw the kitchen sink at this crisis. Billions more in rescue money will flow if it's needed, and Pete, more will be needed.